Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of After Effects Studio with Jeff Knight. It is I, Jeff Knight. Please comment, like, share, subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. And check out our sponsors, Envato Elements and AE Juice. These two companies are fantastic. I don't know how I would get the work done that I do without these two companies. So link in the description below, check them out, and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight sent you. Okay, so if you've seen this series before, I take a look at various ways to do the same thing and then kind of offer up my advice on what I think is the better way. So what I want to talk about today is something I've been doing for years, and it's designing in After Effects. Now, I've talked to other designers who say you need to know Photoshop or Illustrator as much as you know After Effects. I don't think that's possible. I come from the world of doing motion. I don't do much static, so I just don't live in Photoshop that much or Illustrator. Now, I work in Illustrator and Photoshop to a degree. Like, if I have to tear apart an artboard in Illustrator, I know how to do that. I can make basic shapes. I can do some things in Illustrator. But I am not as well-versed in Illustrator as I am in After Effects, nor am I as well-versed in Photoshop as I am in After Effects. That's the way I work. I'm not sure if that's how you guys work, but if it is, there are a few things that I've come across working between After Effects and Photoshop that I think are very important, and some things that will save you some time. So we're gonna go over a design that I created in After Effects and kind of look at it in both After Effects and Photoshop and see what the differences are and how they work together. I'm gonna pull up this design. I opened it up in Photoshop. I've already exported it out. It's a very basic design, but it's not really about the design. It's about the principles that I'm talking about. In this Photoshop file, you know, it's just some basic text, and then we have some shapes and things like that. Now, one of the things that's really important, if you notice over here, these are text layers. I'm going to save this, and I'm going to save it as something unique to make it a different file, so that way you can kind of see from beginning to end what it is I'm doing. So this is my folder for this tutorial here. I'll go into images, and let's just call this PSD sample, okay? Because there's some things I want to show you that you can do in After Effects and in Photoshop, and some things that you can't do. Okay, so I'm going to import that file that I just created, the Photoshop sample. So After Effects Studio, Episodes 4, Images, and Photoshop Sample. And we're going to import it as a composition. And again, we're going to confirm that it is a composition. And now let's just go into this. Okay, so these are all of our Photoshop layers. The thing that's cool about coming from Photoshop to After Effects is that you can actually change these text layers to editable text. So see this No BS Just AE. If you right click and go to create, you can see convert to editable text. Click on that, and now you can change this text to anything you want. So that's true with any file that you bring in from Photoshop into After Effects. So we can just convert all of these right here to editable text, which is cool, and it's very, very helpful. So now the problem comes in when you're designing in After Effects and you go to Photoshop the other direction, that doesn't work. And let me show you what I'm talking about. So I'm just gonna open up the other project file that we just had, which is this file right here. So first, let's focus on the text. Okay, so here's our text here. And one of the things that's important, if I select all these layers and hit S for scale, they're at 100%. In order to do this where it transfers the easiest way to Photoshop is you need to keep your text the scale at 100%. You can make the font size in your character panel any size you want. Say you made this design in After Effects, but the client wants it as a PSD file. So this is what you do. You go to Composition, Save Frame As, Photoshop Layers. And this is very important. You have to do it in this way. So once we do that, I'm gonna save this as something else that's unique. I'll put it in like in a pre-renders, and as you can see, I already have one from earlier. I'm just gonna call this 04, say PSD from AE, just so that way we know this is a unique file, and I want to show you how I'm opening this up. So now the first thing that you'll notice is we have this issue with blending modes. I'm going to get back to that in just a second, but first I want to focus on the text. So let's open up Photoshop, and then I'm going to open up that file that we just saved in my pre-renders folder. It's this right here from AE. Okay, so we're going to open this up, and let's just clear all these guides out here. Okay, so now if you notice, what was editable text, now it's not text. So if I come in here, try to get my text, when I try to edit this No BS, it doesn't know what to do because it's not a text layer. So that is one of the big issues coming from After Effects into Photoshop, is that your text layers will not be editable once you come into Photoshop. However, you can do this. If I double click on this No BS Just AE and I copy it, come over to Photoshop, grab our text tool, and just kind of put it in the general area where our other text is and paste. As you can see, it comes in the same exact font size. So that fits perfectly. And then what I would normally do is just take this other layer that's not editable and delete it. So the main thing you want to focus on going from After Effects to Photoshop when it comes to text is leave your scale at 100%. That we can copy and paste it right over. If you start to mess with your scale, you're going to get a lot of weird issues. Even if it's the same exact size as this, say if I adjusted this, say, to like 90%, but then I messed with my character and the leading and kerning to make it look identical, you're not going to get the same effect. So if you're designing an After Effects and it's text, you need to go from After Effects to Photoshop, make sure that your scale is at 100%. You want to change the size of your text using the character panel only. Okay, so now one of the other issues we have, if we go back to our Photoshop file, you can see our background is filled in all the way, whereas we go back to After Effects, we see we have this kind of design here where we have our background. You can actually see is an alpha matte over this shape here. So if I turn on our shape, this is the shape, this the matte, and then I have our background, which is this right here. I'll take off our alpha matte. So this is what Photoshop is seeing for our background. When I alpha matte it in After Effects, we get this effect where we kind of have this border here. But again, we go back to Photoshop, we see that that didn't happen. And if you remember, whenever I saved it, we got a warning, and I want to save that one more time just to show you what I'm talking about. So let's get rid of this file here. We won't save it. Go back to After Effects, and we're going to go Composition, Save Frame As Photoshop Layers. And I'm just going to save over the other one I have that's from AE. I'm going to replace it, and this warning we get right here is this composition contains track mats or blending modes which are not available in Photoshop. So the issue here is that Photoshop doesn't know what to do with alpha mats that are coming over from After Effects. But there's a workaround. For some reason, and I discovered this a long time ago, while you can't use alpha mats, so let's take off that, and we see our background is goes back to the way it is in Photoshop, which is what we don't want, you can actually add in a set mat. So now with background layer selected, double-click set mat, and we want to set our mat to the shape layer 1, that's our border. So that way we get the same effect we had with the alpha mat. Only difference is we're not using an alpha mat, we're using a set mat. So now let's save that again. So save frame as Photoshop layers. And the one we have is this from AE. So I'm going to save it. And now this time we should not get any errors. And we don't. Okay, so now let's go back over to Photoshop. And let me close this one out. So that way we'll start over. We're going to open up that file we've been saving, this PSD from AE. And so now we see we actually have the background that we wanted. I'm going to get rid of these clear guides right here. So I'm going to zoom in here a little bit. So see, now we have the same background that we designed in After Effects. And the main thing to keep in mind with this is that if you're going from After Effects to Photoshop and you're doing just like a static image, you don't want to use alpha mats. For some reason, Photoshop can't recognize that. It doesn't know how to process it. If you have something that needs to be matted, use set mat, because for some reason, Photoshop does understand set mat. If I were to do something with layer style, so, you know, After Effects has layer styles, you have the same thing in Photoshop. What if I wanted to like add a drop shadow? So we have this drop shadow right here. One of the problems is that when we go over to paste it, the layer style won't follow. Okay, so I just pasted the text in there. Let's get rid of our non-editable text layer, and I'm just going to bring this in. However, one of the things that we can do is we can copy some of the same settings. So see our drop shadows right here. The main thing is the distance is 30, size is 5. So if we go back over to Photoshop, we can right-click on that text layer, go to blending options. We do a drop shadow, and we said that our distance was 30, and I believe our size was 5. And as we can see, that should match. Looks like maybe the angle. Let's make sure it's set at 120. And over here, our blending options. Yeah, see, the angle is at 90, so we'll set that at 120 also. So see, now these two should look pretty much identical, and they do. So I would recommend anything like a drop shadow or anything that you can use a layer style for, you know, your glows, your strokes, things like that. Whatever setting you use for those in After Effects, you can actually use the same exact values in Photoshop and get the same result. Okay, so keep the scale of your text at 100%. Don't use alpha mats, use set mat. And use layer styles for as many effects as you can, because you can always copy those values over and you'll get the same exact effect. I wanted to do this episode because I've worked with people who were like, why would you design a static image in After Effects? Well, a lot of the work I've done has been with film agencies, and a lot of the film agencies in LA, you'll make a static image that will eventually become animation. So a lot of those agencies will have us create static images in After Effects in case they become animated later on. So after years of doing that, I've just focused on After Effects, and that's really the software that I use all the time. The downside is I don't use Photoshop that much. I don't use Illustrator that much, so I'm not as well versed in those. But anything you can do in Illustrator and Photoshop, you can actually do in After Effects. You can get a lot of the same looks. There's something that's a little controversial. I know people who do not agree with me. Leave me your thoughts in the comments below and let me know if you agree with this method. As far as I'm concerned, I'm going to continue designing in After Effects, whether it's for a static or an animated image. And I would love to know what you think and if you've had the same experience as I've had. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a Shape Layer Rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.